Jenny, sweetie, take a seat. We need to have a talk.
Oh, okay. Oh no! They must know it wasn't the cat that ate all that cake. Or maybe they discovered how I clean my room. What's up? Oh, I hope they didn't find my hidden popcorn.
As you know, I haven't been feeling well, so the doctor ran some tests. Now, I don't want you to worry, but we got the results back today, and it turns out I have ovarian cancer.
Don't worry? How can I not worry when Grandma has cancer? I mean, I don't know much about cancer, except that I'm definitely worried. And I don't know anything about...
Deep in outer space, at the headquarters of the Medikids.
Ovarian cancer?
I think we can help with that.
Most definitely.
Pump? Skindy? What's going on?
We heard your grandma has ovarian cancer. We're really sorry, Jenny.
Yeah, we know it's super scary. Even more so when you don't understand what it's all about.
Which is why we're going to take you down to Mediland, a planet that works and looks just like your own body, to learn all about ovarian cancer.
And to do that, we'll start at the ovaries.
Inside an ovary.
Jenny, welcome to an ovary. Women have two ovaries in their bodies.
Whoa, who are those, people?
Those are cells. Your ovaries are made up of millions of them, and they do some really important jobs. Come on, we'll show you. Ovaries make messengers called hormones that travel through the blood all over your body.
Wakey, wakey, hormone! We've got work for you! Let's do it!
A big job the ovaries do is making tiny eggs.
All looks good here!
A quick shine and... ready to go!
So, this is how the ovaries normally work.
Normal sounds good. I'm a big fan of normal.
Have no fear. The party's here.
This is when things stop working normally.
Who is this guy?
Sometimes ovary cells start misbehaving.
We'll make our own rules.
Now what's he doing?
When some ovary cells behave badly, they make more and more cells without stopping.
These cells then group together and form a tumour. Now, some tumours are more dangerous than others. Benign tumours, like this one, stay in one place and do not usually cause problems.
We have moved in and are staying right here.
Malignant tumours are more dangerous. They can spread to nearby tissues or travel to other places in the body. A malignant tumour that starts growing in an ovary is called ovarian cancer.
As it spreads, cancer causes problems in the body depending on where the cells go.
These guys are causing enough problems in here. I definitely wouldn't want them running around my body.
Things are getting really out of control. Time to teleport out of here.
Wow, with that much going on in the ovaries, the doctors must know something's wrong right away, huh?
Actually, ovarian cancer is sneaky. Most women won't notice the problems until the cancer has spread to other parts of the body and starts causing problems.
I remember my grandma had problems eating. She said she always felt bloated.
Yeah, these problems are called symptoms. They're clues that doctors use to figure out what's wrong with your grandma.
There are other symptoms of ovarian cancer besides bloating, like pain in the belly, feeling tired, and feeling like you need to pee all the time.
What can we do to help Grandma?
There's lots we can do. Doctors have a number of treatments they can use to try and get rid of the cancer cells, like surgery, chemotherapy, sometimes called chemo, targeted therapy, hormone therapy, and radiation therapy. Sometimes they'll use a combination of these treatments.
Targeted therapy means treatment personalized to a person's cancer and genes.
Knowing where the cancer is in the body and how far it has spread will help the doctors come up with the best treatments for your grandma.
So, after the treatments, my grandma will be all better, right?
The treatments may help your grandma feel better, but ovarian cancer can be hard to cure, especially if it has spread beyond the ovaries.
Researchers are always looking for better treatments that don't cause side effects. Opportunities may exist to help this research by participating on a clinical trial.
Well, I'm just glad there are treatments to help Grandma.
For sure, but just so you know, cancer treatments can cause side effects. That means your grandma might not always feel great while she's getting treatment.
But don't worry, while some side effects can last longer, most go away a few weeks after stopping treatment. Another cool thing is that your grandma will have her own team of specialists to keep a close eye on her and to help her deal with the disease and treatment.
I just don't understand why my grandma got cancer in the first place. She eats healthily, she exercises, she's a good person.
Your grandma didn't get cancer because of anything she did or didn't do. Doctors and scientists are researching why some people get cancer so we can help prevent anyone from getting it in the future.
What we do know is that women who have family members that have had ovarian, breast or bowel cancer are more likely to get it. Some women, like your grandma, might get it without any of these risk factors.
Ovarian cancer doesn't just happen in older women. Younger women can also be affected by ovarian cancer.
It's not fair.
Jenny.
My grandma doesn't deserve this. I don't want her to have cancer. I don't want her to have to do all those treatments. I'm so scared. I'm scared my grandma's going to die. And it's too much.
We get it, we really do. And we're so, so sorry you and your family are going through this.
Dealing with cancer, it isn't easy. It's a roller coaster of good days that feel like everything is fine, and bad days where you think things will never get better.
And these feelings are normal, Jenny. You're going to feel sad and scared and angry, and that's okay. Let yourself feel those things. You don't have to hide them.
I just feel so alone.
I get that you may feel that way, but let me tell you something. You are definitely not alone. See these lights? Each one represents a kid going through the same thing as you.
Wow, really?
Yeah, and look, your family, friends, and your teachers to lean on if you need help.
What's cool is there are support groups you and your grandma and all the family can go to, where you can meet and talk to people going through the same thing.
I think I'd like that.
As long as you take care of each other and fill your home with love and patience, there's nothing you can't get through.
Thanks, many kids. I feel a lot better now that I know what's going on with my grandma.
I like the sound of that.
Good luck, Jenny. You and your grandma are doing a great job.
A few months later.
All right, Grandma. I've got your pills. You pop the pills and I'll pop the movie into the DVD player.
Jenny, I just want to say I know how hard this is for you. I'm so proud of how well you've been handling it and how helpful you've been.
I love you, Grandma, and as long as we help each other, there's nothing we can't get through.
Thanks, Jenny. Okay, let's start that movie. Oh, I wish we had some popcorn.
Like I said, Grandma, we help each other and have a good time together too.